Hello, 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 Teens 2, how are you? I hope you're fine. So today we're going to learn about present simple, okay? Presente simple. So, in the affirmative form, de manera afirmativa, we use the following structure. Utilizamos la siguiente estructura. So, for he, she, or it, vamos a poner el verbo with super S. ¿Sí? Escribimos el verbo con super S. So, for example, she sleeps every day, okay? Solo para he, she, or it. Then, for I, you, we, and they, we are going to write the verb without the super S. Sin la super S, va I, you, we, and they. For example, they sleep all day. Okay, that's the affirmative form. For the negative form, para he, she, or it, en vez de escribir el verbo con super S, vamos a escribir doesn't, que es el negativo, auxiliar negativo, plus the verb in infinitive, okay? El verbo en infinitivo sin nada, okay? Because the super S, it's already here. La super S está en el doesn't, okay? Doesn't sería una versión con super S de la palabra don't. Okay? So, for I, you, we, and they, we use don't plus the verb in infinitive. Okay? For example, he doesn't sleep all day. She doesn't sleep all day. It doesn't sleep all day. And for I don't sleep all day. You don't sleep all day, and we don't sleep all day. Day is the same. They don't sleep all day. Okay? And then the interrogative form. We start the question with the word does. Empezamos la oración con la palabra does para he, she, or it. Entonces vamos a decir, does he sleep all day? Does she sleep all day? Escuchen. El verbo está también en infinitive, porque la super S ya está en el does. Entonces decimos, does she sleep all day? Okay? And for I, you, we, and they, utilizamos la primera palabra que es do. Okay? En vez de does, vamos a escribir do. Do they sleep all day? El verbo en infinitive también. Do they sleep all day? Do you sleep all day? Do we sleep all day? ¿Se entiende? Muy bien. Ahora, in activity number one, you have to complete with affirmative, en la letra A, la forma afirmativa del present simple. Letter B, the negative form. And letter C, the interrogative form. Okay? Then, in activity number two, you have to complete with the possessive adjectives, los adjetivos posesivos. In the worksheet, you have it explained. Lo tienen explicado en la fotocopia, pero lo voy a explicar también acá. Un adjetivo posesivo, por ejemplo, sería mi, su, sus, nuestros. Y esto es así. Cuando yo digo I, for example, I have got a pencil, para decir que el lápiz es mío, este es mi lápiz, voy a decir this is my pencil. Okay, so, for I, voy a decir my. For he, voy a decir his. For she, her. For it, its. For you, your. For we, our. And they, their. Okay, so, I have got a pencil. This is my pencil. Este lápiz es mío. He has got a pencil. This pencil is his. This is his pencil. Okay? Vamos con you. You have got a pencil. This is your pencil. And we have got a pencil. This is our pencil. Okay, so I hope that helped. Espero que haya ayudado. So activity number two, in number letter A, you have to complete with the possessive adjectives. And then letter B, you have to underline, subrayar, the correct answer, la respuesta correcta. And letter C, you have to complete with the possessive adjectives too. And in activity number three, you have to complete with present simple, okay? Tengan cuidado y presten mucha atención y lean bien los sujetos para saber si tenemos que escribir con la super S o sin la super S, okay? So I hope this helped. Espero que haya ayudado. Les mando un beso gigante and see you next class.